This video is a quick pit stop where I show you how to create a Power BI calculated column before I move on to my favorite topic, Power BI measures. Keep watching. Hey, 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 we are ready to define our first calculation. So here we are in our sales table, and we have our sales amount and tax amount. And the first calculation we'll try to define is a total sales amount, which is a sum of both of these. Now, if you notice up at the ribbon over here, in the modeling tab, you have this calculation pane, and ignore this new table for now. But really the key ones are either you can define a new measure or a new column, all right? So first of all, let's save this file. And we're gonna go take a peek at the file itself. So this is 3761 kilobytes. I'm gonna write that down. Where's my notepad? There we go. 3761 KB. Perfect. All right, so I have that. And I'm gonna come back here. And I'm going to define a new column. All right, this is just one of the available calculation types. So I'm gonna say new column. And great, I see this new column added here, but really the key is the formula bar here. So I have column and I can change that name and I'll say total sales amount. All right, total sales amount equals, and I'm gonna use the column name, sales amount, perfect. All right, so you notice that it auto completes. Let's look that closer up. So I'm here in my formula bar, and let's see that again. So if I were to type in sales amount, it just narrows it down, and then I can hit the tab key on my keyboard to complete it. And plus, the other one is tax amount, and there we go. And I can just hit enter, and my column has been added, right? It's just summing these two up. Change the formatting if I wanted to. Let's change that to zero decimal places, make it look a little cleaner. And if you notice here that it has a slightly different icon to indicate that it is a calculated column, so total sales amount. But what I really wanted to show you was that I'm going to save this file again. And if I go back, notice the size here is 3789. Right, so that's key, that after I added a calculated column, the size grew. Oh boy, you can't see that. There you go, right? It went from 3761 to 3789. Now this is a very, very small data set. Any real production data set is gonna be far larger than this. And I'm gonna come back and talk about the impact of this. Now, by the way, so between these two new measures and new column, I see Excel users inevitably gravitate towards new column, and they keep creating these columns and additional columns, and right, and they keep creating these here, which may feel natural for Excel user, but it's not really the way you wanna go with Power BI desktop. Any math you wanna perform, typically you would wanna create a measure. Now there are going to be scenarios where you wanna create a calculated column. We'll cover those later, but I would say your default should be that if there's a calculation, it should be a measure. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.